Is Editor X worth the price? In this video, I'm going to share why I think it's not only worth the price, but how it can save you potentially hundreds of dollars in monthly software expenses. Hey friends, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey and I'm a web designer. I had a comment on one of my previous videos, which basically said, hey, it would be helpful if you talked about the cost of Editor X, which is not free. In fact, it's quite expensive. Great point. So let's talk about it. But first, two things. One, Editor X is free. It also offers paid plans. Two, I am partnered with Editor X, which means I do have a bias here.
Oh, just a little bit.
Just to get that out there. That said, I'll make it very clear who should and who should not be paying for a premium plan of Editor X. Without further ado, what is Editor X? Since you're watching this video, you probably already have an idea of what Editor X is. A web creation platform with advanced design capabilities, so it's priced accordingly. You can build and launch unlimited sites for free, then choose a premium plan when you want to connect a custom domain, accept online payments, incorporate e-commerce, and a lot more. Okay, so how much does Editor X cost? Well, they have a free plan that lets you build anything and launch as many websites as you want. There's no annoying restrictions that you usually get with freemium software, as far as I'm concerned. And as soon as you want to upgrade to professional features like connecting your own domain name, remove Editor X branding, accept payments, have a large amount of video storage, ad vouchers, and a lot more, then you gotta pay up. They offer quite a few plans for smaller projects and freelancers, and more robust plans for businesses and e-commerce sites. Prices start around $20 a month and range all the way up to about $200 a month for bigger companies and with bigger needs. So who's Editor X for and who's it not for? Well, let's start with who it's not for. If you're a hobbyist and you make zero money from web design, or you're really married to a certain programming language or a certain platform, maybe Editor X is just not for you. And that's okay. That said, you can always create and launch your websites on Editor X using the free account and then see if it suits your needs and go from there. Okay, so who is it for? When I started freelancing, I didn't make very much money, so I was hesitant to spend any money on my business whatsoever. I quickly found out that you really have to spend some money to make some money. Believe me, I really stressed a lot about paying $12 per month for an invoicing software. I'm grateful that I did in hindsight. Now, Editor X is made for professional designers, agencies, freelancers, and creative professionals who get paid to build things for the web. These folks, they're generally not afraid to spend money on tools. Now, at this point, it's important to make a distinction between value and price. They're two very different things. I'm a Tommy Tightwad when it comes to spending money on personal purchases. Like, I'll go out of my way and drive across town to pick up the pizza I ordered rather than spend $7 on delivery fees and tips, even though I'm probably paying more on gas. But in my business, I'll spend thousands of dollars in a blink if I'm confident that what I get in return is more valuable than the money I parted with in order to get it, kind of like an investment. Now, value doesn't just mean money earned. It could also mean money saved or time saved. Even emotional labor costs something. If doing something stresses you out, then maybe you can pay to have that done for you. For example, I'll easily pay $100 per month for a software that either saves me more than $100 a month in expenses, makes me more than $100 in revenue per month, or provides me more than $100 of time saved. So if I value my time at, let's say, $100 an hour, and said software saves me 10 hours per month in effort, then do the math. And you'll quickly find out that you're basically obligated as a business owner to make that deal. So consumers look to save money at every turn. Professionals look for value and return. And they might be the exact same person. Got it? Okay, now that you know who Editor X is for, how much it costs, what you get for that price, and whether or not you're looking at the price from a personal or professional perspective, let me drive this point home by sharing an interview that I had with Art West from NoCodeDevs, who apparently saves more than $700 a month by consolidating his entire no-code software subscription stack into just EditorX. So, let's find out how he makes this happen, and then we shall truly know if EditorX is worth the price. Let's do that. Hey, Art, how's it going, man?
Hey, Brad, thanks for having me.
Good. Oh, yeah, totally. Thanks for coming on. I really appreciate your time.
Yeah, it's good to be here and good to talk EditorX.
Yeah, man. So tell me, before we kind of get into it, I have a few questions for you, but I want to know for everybody watching, you know, like, who are you? What's your deal? Give us a little bit of 101 on Art.
Yeah, for sure. So my name is Art West. I run the NoCodeDevs website and community. And essentially, we're a no-code tools software directory where anyone can come to our site, get sort of the latest scoop on no-code tools, find the right tool for their solution, and also participate in our community, which is everything from a forum to live workshops, and you know, even our Twitter community as well can be lumped into there, I guess.
Sweet. So then how did you get into no-code? Like, how did that come into your world?
Yeah, so really, I had been into no-code well before people were calling it no-code. I was a project manager in a totally different industry, and I was always frustrated by not being a, you know, a software developer or designer or anything like that, but I needed to, you know, develop solutions to help my projects run better. And of course, we didn't have an IT budget or any sort of in-house development. So I was sort of forced to figure it out myself. I would sort of hack solutions together with different tools, which were much different than they are today. But nonetheless, I was able to sort of figure out these no-code tools that would work to help manage my projects. Fast forward, you know, to present, somewhere in between there, I came across the no-code community, I believe on Twitter, and I sort of had this light bulb moment that was like, oh, well, this is exactly what I'm doing. I never heard the term no-code, but essentially I'm a no-code developer. So I embraced the community, started NoCodeDevs, and a weekly, bi-weekly newsletter, which is still running today. We're about 350 issues on that newsletter. So we sort of just stay up to date with what's happening and share our learnings with the community.
Nice. Yeah, that's cool. That's neat. That's cool to hear. And it's cool to see that you have like a community that you've built around that whole topic. So it's like having a group of people where if you come across, you know, I'm trying to achieve this outcome, but I don't know how to do it. And I tried this and Zapier or this, and you know, you have a group of people that can help you figure that out. That's cool.
Yeah, so, absolutely.
With that said, what no code, like what was your no code tech stack that you used prior to, you know, what we're really going to be talking about here in a few moments, but like what were all the tools that you were using?
Yeah, it's hard to sort of get them all in one list. Just to say, we were probably using somewhere between 15 and 20 total no code tools to run our entire business and community. So our core stack prior to migrating to EditorX was Webflow, Zapier, and Airtable. That was sort of like our core stack, and that ran everything. But as you can imagine, when you're running a community that has 7,000 plus members and a CMS that has thousands of items, it starts to get pretty interesting when you're running all this through Zapier. And Zapier is great, but you know, if there's an error, it's really hard to figure out where it is. And there just becomes a lot of complication when you're, you know, stringing a bunch of applications together like that.
That sounds expensive. Like, that's a lot of subscriptions, right?
Yeah. Well, you're right on both. Very, very expensive. A lot of subscriptions. I think in the upper end, some of these tools were $200 US a month. So as you can imagine, it quickly adds up, which is a pain point for sure. For me, the biggest pain point is the point of failure. A lot of these tools, because they're sort of they're not developer tools, right? So a lot of times the error reporting is very general, just like, oh, hey, this broke, here's a general error message, but it doesn't really tell you what happened. So then, you know, as a consequence, you just get, you know, unhappy customers, but you really don't know what went wrong. So the only solution is to be like, well, let's just try it again and hope it works. So, you know, that's hard to swallow when it's also very expensive, right? So if it's very expensive, it should work and you should be able to be in complete control of your application. So yeah, I think both of those together made it very hard and frustrating to, you know, run a business smoothly. You can't totally always get out of that, but you can eliminate a lot of that risk, I think, by sort of like bundling your tech stack into a more robust tool.
Cool. Okay. So that's a good segue into Little Birdie tells me you've been able to consolidate many, if not most, maybe even all of those tools into EditorX.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Almost unbelievably, we've been able to migrate everything for our core business into EditorX. So use some of these other tools here and there for some light things, but mostly they're outside of the business actually at this point. So really everything is run entirely within EditorX at this point, from automations to email marketing, to community and everything in between. We can get into those a little bit more sort of specifically, but yes, I have been able to consolidate everything in EditorX.
How much do you think roughly did all of those tools cost prior to maybe consolidating and canceling some of those subscriptions?
Yeah, I actually was so sort of starstruck coming into this platform that I went through and I did the rough math, and it came out to be somewhere in the ballpark of about $700 US a month. So a pretty significant chop of savings there that I was able to realize just by eliminating these tech stacks. And like I sort of spoke to earlier, also eliminating a lot of headaches. So I now have this one, you know, really centralized dashboard where I can quickly hop between my functional apps without having to go to like another URL, another login, you know, all that kind of stuff.
That's a huge thing. Like as a business owner, you're running a community, you're running a business, saving, you know, expenses, cutting expenses is brilliant. So like 700, if you're spending $700 a month, you know, it's like what, $8,400 a year or something like that. If you're bringing in like $100,000 a year in revenue, that's like 10% of your revenue.
Cost aside, I would be, you know, making this choice just from the point of consolidation. So the cost is like an extra benefit that we're realizing. But you know, aside from that, just having this consolidated dashboard, you know, where we can manage everything with one unified login makes it incredibly powerful. And speaking to staff, you can get to the granular permission level and provide access to, you know, all of the, you know, apps within your app, so to speak. So you can say, oh, hey, I have this marketing manager or this, you know, the staffer who's writing emails. Okay, I'm going to give that person only access to the email module within EditorX. So you have all that like granular permissions that, you know, a lot of these third-party tools don't even have sort of sub users. So you're sharing logins, you're kicking each other out. All that sort of headache stuff just completely goes away by switching to EditorX. Awesome. So, you know, this, if you haven't seen EditorX before, this is sort of their dashboard home base. Navigating on the left panel here where there's all these different types of tools, and this will look different depending on what modules you've installed, you know, sort of into your experience, into your tool base. So it's very specific on based upon what you need. There's some core things here, but just to touch on a few that we use. So within the marketing and SEO tab, I find this incredibly powerful because we could do all of our email marketing right here in EditorX. As you can see, we've sent 13,000 emails. We just switched to EditorX, by the way. So we're sending all of our sort of marketing emails right in EditorX. You have your SEO tools. You can do social posts. A lot of these I'm not even using, but there's just like a ton in here. It's super deep, even within the marketing and SEO channel. It has a, for our community, this was a big one because we were on Circle, which Circle is just like a sort of like a forum building, white label forum building software package. We've been able to move our entire forum into to Editor X. And what's really cool about Editor X is that Editor X has users. So you can have users within Editor X, and then you have users within your forum. And depending on what package your users are on, let's say you had like a free tier and then a premium tier, you could actually control which pages within the forum, or for that matter, which pages within any pages on your site that user has access to, depending on what plan they're on. So you can get really deep in terms of what you want your users to do and what you want your users to see on your site. So we really, really like that. For me, one of the coolest things that we talked about previously was like Zapier and automations. So they have like a whole automation studio where you're able to like build these sort of like logic-based events based on what's happening with your site. So, you know, somebody arrives, you know, to your page, you could send them, you know, an automated chatbot message, which by the way, they also have a chatbot. So that's just like another app that's built within Editor X that you can just turn on. You can do email automations, drip campaigns, all kinds of crazy stuff, all within this automation tool. And it even integrates, like if you were running e-commerce, it even integrates with e-commerce, so you can do abandoned cart sort of like automations and things like that.
If you're running your own business, obviously you're doing that now primarily in the Editor X dashboard, business manager, let's call it.
Yep.
So you could do that for your own business, but then also if you are like, if you are a freelance web designer and you get clients, or maybe you're an agency, you know, you're a design agency, creative agency, a web design agency, and you get clients, these are things that you can offer clients and pass that value to them and then charge accordingly. So instead of just, yeah, we'll build your site, it's like, we can set up your membership, we can manage your invoicing, we could, you know, advance, let's say, for example, you get a client and they're like a dance studio or a yoga studio or some sort of thing, and they need a calendar, an events calendar, a membership platform that they can have, you know, members who are behind gated content, maybe a blog, and, you know, pay for like an event or pay for a session or whatever it is. You could literally hand that booking calls. You could hand that off to them and say like, yeah, we will design, build, and put this whole thing together so it's all managed in one place, and we can offer that to you and then charge accordingly for that.
Their tool is incredibly robust, that's user friendly enough, you know, for somebody who just wants to build sort of like a simple landing page site with like integrated payments, to do that. But I really think it is geared towards designers. It's definitely a design heavy tool. If you want to really get into the weeds in designing something beautiful on the front end, you know, Editor X is for you, especially like e-commerce. This is a great way. You know, I think Shopify is wonderful, but you're very much bound to the templates and the themes that they have available. And they really all start to look, you know, the same. And if you want custom development outside of that, it is very, very, very expensive. This would allow you to, you know, build a e-commerce shop pretty easily, make it unique to your own business, so you have your own sort of true design, but you'd also be able to run all the automations and business logic. I would encourage anybody who's on the fence or, you know, curious about checking out, just to get in there and start building something. And really, I don't think you're going to see any cost at all until you actually go ahead and publish, or you pay for some module that has a cost, but that's few and far between. I think for the most part, you're going to be able to get in there, see the power of what it can do, and just, you know, write down on a piece of paper all the savings that you're going to see and realize, and then you can make that decision if it's right for you.
That's awesome. Wow. Art, I really appreciate your time. Thanks for showing us that. And before you go, actually, I should, where can people find more about you and your community too? I'll let you kind of plug that.
Yeah, thanks. NoCodeDevs.com is our website, and NoCodeDevs on all socials, everything from Twitter to TikTok. So we're out there, you know, at NoCodeDevs.
Sweet. All right, Art, thanks so much.
Yeah, thanks, Brad.
Cheers. So what do you think? Have you tried the free Editor X account yet? Maybe you're paying for a premium version of Editor X. I'd love to know your thoughts, your experiences, and your opinions. Drop them in the comments below. And until next time, that was strange. I won't do that again. Unless, we're not going to do that again.